Good morning. Welcome to Santa Cruz Parish. In respect for God in our celebration, and for all here worshiping, we ask that all cell phones be silenced. Don't leave personal items in the pews. All children must be accompanied by an adult when going to the courtyard or bathroom, and we kindly ask you not to chew gum in church. Our end song. The presider for our Mass is Father Matthias. Please stand.
Oh, great thou art. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. God, that always pondering spiritual things we may carry out in both word and deed that which is pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to the whole Israelite community and tell them, 'Be holy, for I, the Lord, your God, am holy. You shall not bear hatred for your brother or sister in your heart, though you may have to reprove your fellow citizen. Do not incur sin because of him. Take no revenge and cherish no grudge against any of your people. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord.'" The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that you are the temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person, for the temple of God, which you are, is holy. Let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you considers himself wise in this age, let him become a fool so as to become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the eyes of God, for it is written, God catches the wise in their own ruses. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are vain. So let no one boast about human beings, for everything belongs to you, Paul, or Apollos, or Cephas, or the world, or life, or death, or the present, or the future. All belong to you, and you to Christ, and Christ to God. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye, and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, offer no resistance to one who is evil. When someone strikes you on your right cheek, turn the other one as well. If anyone wants to go to law with you over your tunic, hand over your cloak as well. Should anyone press you into service for 1 mile, go for 2 miles. Give to the one who asks of you, and do not turn your back on one who wants to borrow. You have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father. For he makes his sun rise on the bad and the good, and causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what recompense will you have? Do not the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet your brothers only, what is unusual about that? Do not the pagans do the same? So be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect."
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, my name is Father Matthias of the Immaculate Heart. I'm one of the discalced Carmelite friars, like your Father Stephen, Father David, Father Julius, but I'm in San Jose, California at our novitiate, and I brought with me two of our novice brothers, Brother Charbel Mary and Brother Teresio. If you could keep them in prayer as they're offering their entire lives to God. They're in the initial stages of that. But thanks be to God, they're responding to his call. And be sure, when we're on our way back, driving up to San Jose, we're going to remember you all and your intentions and our prayers, too. Just a little, got to clear the air. I was trying right before the Mass to get this lipstick stain out of the tunic. I don't know if you can see that. Maybe on this side. I don't want anybody scandalized. What's going on? I had the 8 a.m. Mass at the Capilla de Guadalupe, and I think one of the viejitas, con un abrazo, yeah, it got stuck there, so. Don't worry. Can you believe that Ash Wednesday is this Wednesday? Lent is coming up super fast. And in 2 weeks, I'm going to be driving back down from San Jose, California to be with you all for the weekend masses, as well as for a mission, the 6th, 7th, and 8th of March, spilling into the 9th. I will be giving your Lenten mission during that time. Please start praying now. If you are a prayer warrior, for all of those who God is calling to come, I hope you all will come during the mission, because God is ready to pour out his Holy Spirit in deep and personal grace of healing, of strengthening, for any shackles to be broken, anything holding you back from moving forward in life, to having an abundant life that is the Christian life that is the call. And if you're more so there, and we're all a work in progress, let's go deeper. So the theme of this mission that's coming up in 2 weeks is encountering Jesus, but in a deeper way, in the most holy Eucharist, in our prayer, and in our sufferings, learning to embrace him and find him all the more there. The last night of the evening masses and guided prayer with adoration that are going to be Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, March 6th, 7th, and 8th, the last night after the Mass, we'll have a powerful healing service with adoration and processing with our Lord in the Blessed Sacrament to give you time to encounter him in intimacy, to reach out to him, and to find that healing like they found in the gospel. So please invite others too, friends, family, who've drifted away since the pandemic, whatever's happening, tell them, come check it out. More information will be in the bulletin as well, in a flyer next weekend. So let's turn to the Lord's word to us today in our scriptures. Jesus says to each one of us, this is the challenge, you have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father. I don't know about you, I want to be a child of my heavenly Father, not one with a hard heart. In 1944, there was a young family in Poland during the time of the Nazi occupation. This family was called the Ulma family. They had six kids aged 2 to 8 years old. The mom was pregnant, 7 months pregnant with her seventh child. This family was taught by the Nazis during that time to hate their enemies, the Jews. The family, thanks be to God, did not listen to the Nazis. They listened to Jesus Christ. One day, this was March 24th, 1944, the Nazis came on a patrol, and they discovered at their home, their farm in Poland, 8 Jewish people that this family was hiding from the Nazis. I don't know how long, months, a year. They're risking their lives in doing this, in loving those who were their enemies. The Nazis executed each one of the Jews, and then they turned their guns on the parents, Joseph and Victoria, and they killed them. When the children were crying, seeing this happen, they turned their guns on the children and killed each of their children. This is extremely tragic. Somebody entered the house after the mayhem, and they found in the family's home a Bible. As they looked at the Bible, they saw in the parable of the Good Samaritan, who helped his enemy on the side of the road who was injured, they found it underlined in red pen in that family. You better believe that family, each of them was the children of their Heavenly Father, with no doubt of eternal life in heaven in God's presence. So much so that the church is now beatifying the entire family this September. Pope Francis will beatify them en route to being declared saints. Even the little one in her mother's womb is being beatified. That's a first as far as I know. Isn't that incredible? A baby in the womb being beatified as well. Thanks be to God for this witness in these times. Thanks be to God for this family, the Ulma family's yes to God, to love even when it might cost them everything. Brothers and sisters, loving our enemies, praying for them, it's a true mark of the Christian. It's one thing that sets us apart. We can't do it on our own. It's too much. It's not natural in a sense in our fallen condition. But in Jesus, it absolutely is possible, and it changes the world. Now thousands, tens of thousands, and millions of people are hearing this family story, as well as the grace that's flowing from this act of love. Let me offer you a few tips. And what follows to help us to love, to forgive, we're not talking about enduring abuse, okay? But everyday slights, rejections, persecutions, harsh words that make others our enemies, even if it's just temporarily, you know, even a parent, a sibling, in that moment you're ready to go, punch them in the face. I'm reminded of a story. Maybe I'll share this in 2 weeks, but Mother Teresa of Calcutta, Saint Teresa of Calcutta, our confirmandi, the teenagers here. Have you all heard of Mother Teresa of Calcutta? Some, yes, no? Mother Teresa. Please Google her if you haven't. She died in 1997. It's incredible. The world knew her as a saint on earth. Saint Mother Teresa was walking along the street in Calcutta one day. This is India. And she came across a little girl who was abandoned, who was alone, nobody to care for her. The girl was crying. There was a cafe across the street. There's a bunch of men sitting in there. They're eating sumptuously as this girl was crying. She went up to her and said, "Are you hungry?" And the girl said, "Yes," as she was consoling her. So she went up to the men at the cafe. She said, "Sirs, could you spare anything to eat for this little girl?" One of the men stood up, looked at Mother Teresa. Well, didn't look up to her, looked down. Mother Teresa was like 4'11" tall. And what he did, he spat in her face. He spat in her face. Could you imagine that? Mother Teresa proceeds to look up at him, and she punched him in the face. Boom! Knocked him down. He goes, "No, she did not do that. She didn't do that." Okay. Mother Teresa, as the saliva, lavaba, is sliding down her face, she says, "Okay, that was for me, but how about for the little girl?" Food. In that moment, she didn't give in to her enemy, somebody. She rose above. Boy, you could believe her blood was probably boiling a little bit, but no, She kept focus. What about the little girl? It's not about me. So let me offer a few tips here, brothers and sisters. Number one out of three, we can quickly free ourselves from hurts before they fester into deep animosity and division. This is possible. We have the tools as Christians to do this. When we find ourselves getting angry, first of all, the battle isn't lost. Anger is an emotion. Sometimes we think, oh, I sinned because I felt angry at somebody. No, it's what you do with that emotion, right? Like fear, like other emotions, joy, attraction, whatever it might be. There's an emotion there. What you do is what's important. For one, almost nothing good comes about if we react in that moment, right? Your blood's boiling, you're ready to go to the person, or just talk back. Almost never does something good happen in that moment, speaking from anger, hatred, resentment, whatever. Picking up your cross, as Jesus said, can be as simple as just biting your tongue for a moment. Maybe leaving the room, calming down with the help of prayer. And then we can deal with it with a more level-headed way. That often diffuses others too. They're ready for a fight, right? Pick up your cross, bite your tongue. Let it pass in that moment. That's number one. Number two, whatever's going on, the anger, the resentment, the hurt, feel it deeply. Sounds crazy, right? We want to find ways out. Like little babies, their parents' arms were like, we're struggling against it. I don't want this. We don't. But there was a young saint that once said, and she suffered and died of a terrible bone disease at 19 years old, and yet she was beaming with joy. Blessed Chiara Luce Badano once said, embraced pain makes one free. Embraced pain makes one free. Try it. It's true. The quicker we can accept our pain or the emotion, whatever's going on, the sooner we'll be able to free ourselves. It's possible, because by embracing the pain, the emotion, we stop struggling against it, trying to get away from it, which is painful in itself. You feel it deeply in that moment, accept it, embrace it. And then because we're Christians, it's not like we want pain, right? It's there. Find Jesus in there. He entered into every one of our pains through the cross to this very day, so we can find God present there. So he can be our light, our healing, our help through that pain. So you make a shift and then you embrace him. Find him there, speak to him, and then you offer it. Okay, we're going to talk more about that during the mission. But number three, lastly, pray for your enemy, forgive them, look for an opportunity to show them kindness. If we do this, we'll be a true child of our Heavenly Father. Sounds really tough, right? St. John of the Cross, where is he? There and here. Who helped to found our Order of Discalced Carmelites. He once said, this is in the midst of being persecuted by his brothers, where there is no love, put love, and there you will draw out love. Where there's no love, put love, and then you will draw out love. Speaking of forgiveness, there's a common lie that tells us, if I forgive them, I let them off the hook, right? They're not learning their lesson, whatever's going on, I gotta teach them, I gotta be their judge, their jury to help them. Maybe with kids, those you're taking care of, it's different. Yes, forgive, but you have to teach and correct. It's a lie the evil one sows to think, because ultimately God is the judge, perfect judge. He sees clearly. Yes, he wants to save everybody, but everything, every word, every action, good or bad, It's held accountable. And yes, there's forgiveness, but God is the judge. Commend them to God. Forgiveness is not the same as reconciliation. Okay? Reconciliation, that takes two. That's both of you. The Lord asks us to forgive, and he wants us to reconcile, but sometimes people are not open to it. But for us, that's letting go, getting out of that prison of hurt, of anger that we've gotten stuck in, saying, I'm not going to be stuck there. This isn't going to define me. I'm going to move forward. And because it's too much for us to forgive, it's too hard. It's not natural. Pray in Jesus' name. I choose to forgive. Say their name. And then, four, be specific. Call it out into the light. This could be on your own. In the quiet of your heart, you're praying this in Jesus' name. Because God, I need your help with your power. I choose to forgive. Say their name. Four, blank. Pray that as much as you need so you can move forward. It's a process of healing for us. And then we're free. Then we can deal with things. Give them to God. So brothers and sisters, we turn to Jesus in this most holy Eucharist. Him who went to the cross for us, who loved us as we were crucifying him with our sins. Each one of us who loved us. Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. And who did that to rescue us unto heaven. So we turn to him as we anticipate him in Holy Communion. We ask him for the grace to forgive as he has forgiven us. If we don't forgive others, we're not open to God's forgiveness as Jesus teaches us. Just before we move on for a rite, for the confirmandi present here, I ask you all in just a brief moment of silence to pray that prayer. If there's one person, even if you're doing pretty well, there's not a whole lot of hurt left, but there's still a bit, pray that prayer, okay? Close your eyes for a moment. In the presence of Jesus, call to mind somebody who has wronged you, especially recently, maybe it's in the past. Maybe they wronged a loved one of yours. It's hard to bring this into the light, but it's good. Then we can let the divine physician heal. Commend them to God, to him as judge. Lord, you take care of it. Handle them. And then please pray this prayer with me. You can do it quietly, silently. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. I choose to forgive. I choose to forgive. Say their name. Four, name it. Pray that as much as you need. You've just broken. Sometimes there's an oppression from the evil one keeping us bound. That's breaking that. That's moving forward. Ask in this moment for the confirmandi, for their sponsors to please stand.
Strength. they will enter into a period of conversion and purification as they prepare to be fully initiated into the Catholic faith.
Those who desire to complete their initiation into the Church, please stand. Thank you for standing. Candidates, during this period of conversion and purification, you will reflect upon the mystery of your baptism, that's the beginning of eternal life, and come to appreciate more deeply the presence of Jesus Christ in your lives. Therefore, prepare yourselves during these weeks of Lent through conversion from sin and purification of your mind and heart. Your sponsors will now present you with a wooden cross. If you would hold those crosses up, I'd like to bless them. Heavenly Father, bless these crosses that they might be a powerful witness and sign of the love of your Son who saved us from our sins and brings us to heaven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This cross is a reminder that you must be willing to carry your cross as the Lord Jesus was willing to carry his. Sponsors, please state your candidate's name now. And then repeat, receive this cross. You are called to conversion and purification. And to service in God's church and his people. Okay, please place the cross on your candidates. Now, candidates, please kneel. Candidates, please repeat. Look down upon me. Good and gentle Jesus, take and receive all my liberty, my memory, my understanding, and my whole will. Before I bless you, know that that's kind of a scary prayer to pray. It's like, what's he going to do with my memory, my will, my understanding? He's for you. He's not against you. You can, it's the best to do that. He wants you happy and fully alive. So please bow your heads. Lord our God, you created us in love and redeemed us in mercy through the blood of your Son. Enlighten these candidates by your grace, that clearly seeing their sins and failings, they may place all their trust in your mercy and resist all that is deceitful from the evil one and the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay. You may be seated. Brothers and sisters, this, as we did this, we will omit the creed, and please stand to offer our prayers of intercession.
For the church, the temple of God, that her holiness may shine out in the world, especially the witness of her universal love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are wise in this age, the powerful and the influential, that they may be given the grace to understand God's wisdom and turn their efforts to justice, life, and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our enemies, for our persecutors, for those who press us into service and take what is ours, that we may have the grace to return more good to them than the evil they have done to us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus, who has taken us far beyond the provision of the old law, may have the joy of seeing us become perfect as our Heavenly Father is perfect. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering and heavily burdened, that the Lord may heal all their ills, redeeming their life from destruction, crowning them with kindness and compassion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For special intentions of Pueblo High School administration and community, for whom this Mass is offered, that he may receive blessings through the intercession of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, that they may be placed before the Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Finally, we pause for a moment in silence, and we present to our Heavenly Father the petitions we carry within our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for always hearing our prayers and answering them according to your will, your timing, which is perfect. As we make our prayer in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Right.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
As we celebrate your mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly ask you that what we offer to the honor of your majesty may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, We make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, Alberto, our Bishop, and all those who holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Peter, Felicity, Marcellinus, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Hatred, let me bring your love. Lord, lead me on.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may experience the effects of salvation, which is pledged to us by these mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our preparation for Easter 2023 begins this Wednesday, on Ash Wednesday. For 40 days, we will give more attention to prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. We will have an additional Mass on weekdays at 7 p.m. during Lent, this Thursday, February 23rd, with Adoration. Please join us for Stations of the Cross every Friday of Lent at 6:30 in the church. The Knights of Columbus will put on the traditional fish fry on Fridays in the hall from 5:30 to 8. There will be a parish mission from March 5th through the 8th, given by Father Matthias. Next weekend, we will have a second collection for the Black and Indian missions. And I believe we have a young lady today who's celebrating a birthday. Could Clarissa please come forward?
We'll see you in 2 weeks as well. Know that on the last day, the 9th, that's a Thursday, there's going to be multiple priests coming from around to hear confessions. So Thursday the 9th will be a reconciliation service.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.